I'm going to tell you how can you solve these types of question. Normally these are the question for the indeterminate problems. So how can we do that? And this question is from the strength of material, and also I want to tell you here is that this question I have taken from the strength of material book by Singer. Okay, then a copper rod is inserted into a hollow aluminium cylinder. A copper rod is inserted into a hollow aluminium cylinder. The copper rod projects 0.005 inches as shown in the figure. That what does it mean by that? I will tell you in the diagram. What maximum load P may be applied to the bearing plate? So we have to determine what we have to find out the value of P. Use the data in the following table. So where is the data? I will tell you here. This is the data in the table given to you. And this is the diagram. It is also given in the book with this question. So what we have to tell you here is that this one is the copper rod. This one is the copper rod, and this is aluminium. So a copper rod is inserted between the hollow aluminium cylinder. So this is copper rod, and this one is the aluminium cylinder. So what we have to do, the point load, or you can say the load is applied on this piston over here, and what we have to do, look here, that this is Dawa deformation of copper. This will be the copper deformation, and this is deformation of aluminium. So limit of aluminium deformation is up till here. So when we push this piston, so it can come over here, but for copper it is up to here. So what we have to, we cannot go down from this line. So we have the limit of pressing, after pressing. So what we have limit deformation is up till this, and this extra length of copper is given to you, that is given in the question, that is 0.005 inches. So what we have to write it down here, it is 0.05 inches. So let me write it down. So I wrote it by mistake. So it is 0.05 inches. So you can write it like this. So what we have to do, we have to find out the value of this P. And for this diagram, one more thing I have to tell you. The length of this aluminium cylinder, or height of aluminium cylinder, is 10 inches. So what we have to do here, we have to use this data from the table. So copper and aluminium is here. The area of a copper, the area for the copper is 2 inches square, and the area for aluminium is 3 inches square. And modulus of elasticity in pounds per inch square is 17 into 10 to the power 6 for copper, and 10 is to 10 into 10 to the power 6 is aluminium. Or you can say it's for aluminium. Allowable stress in KSI for copper is 20 KSI, and for aluminium is 10 KSI. So what we have to do, and how can we solve this numerical? So let me start the solution. In this diagram, what we have to do in this question, we have to first find out maximum allowable, maximum allowable, maximum allowable deformation in the copper. So how can we find out? So deformation in copper is equals to sigma maximum stress maximum into L upon E. L is the length, and this is modulus of elasticity. So Dawa copper is equals to 20 into 1000. Why is it 1000? So allowable stress is given to us for the copper is 20, so we have to multiply with 1000 because it is given in the KSI. So we want it in PSI, so we should have to multiply. Then the length of the of this is 10 inches for aluminium, and when we add 0.005 inches, so it is very small amount for the copper. So we can use 10 inches, or if you want to use this, so you can use 10.005 inches. So this will be 10 divided by 17. This is modulus of elasticity of the copper, power 6. So Dava copper is coming out to be 0.01176 inches. So this will be the deformation in the copper. You can see here what I have done. Maximum allowable Dava Cu copper, Cu is used for copper, Dava Cu sigma maximum into L upon E. So we will put the value of allowable stress for the copper 20 into 1000 into 10 upon 17 into 10 to the power 6. So Dava copper is equals to 0.01176 inches. So what we have to do next, we have to subtract it to find out what Dava aluminium. So how can we do that? Let me tell you. For this, Dava aluminium limit is what? 0.01176 inches, this is Dava of copper, minus 0.005 inches that was given in the question for the copper. So we will subtract this, so it will come out 0.00676 inches. This will be the limit for the Dava aluminium. Or you can say deformation. Now what we have to do, maximum possible deformation for aluminium. So how can we do that? Maximum possible Dava aluminium. So it will be Dava aluminium equals to sigma maximum into L over E. So what will happen? We will put sigma maximum of aluminium. So where is the sigma maximum of aluminium is given to us? Stress for aluminium is given to us 10 KSI. So we will put 10 into 1000. Length is given to us 10, and the value of E is what? 10 into 10 to the power 6 for aluminium. So 10 into 10 to the power 6, and this will be equals to 0.01 inches. 0.01 inches. So what we have to do, we have the limit of 0.01 inches for maximum, we have maximum allowable deformation for aluminium. So what we have to do, we have to put or write down these values. Dava for copper is coming out to be 0.01176 inches, and Dava aluminium is 0.01 inches maximum, and the Dava aluminium, when we subtract it for this, so it is coming out to be 0.00676 inches. So what we have to do, we will put Dava aluminium 0.00676 inches, because we cannot go for this. Why is it so? Because we have 0.01176 inches, it is a Dava of copper, and Dava aluminium is coming out to be 0.01 inches, but we cannot go down from this now. So what we have to do, we have to find out the value of P aluminium. So for this, what we have to do, Dava aluminium is equals to P aluminium upon A dot L over E. So we have to put this value 0.006676. 0.006676 inches equals to P of aluminium divided by area of aluminium is 3. It was given to us, yes, aluminium's area was given in the table, into 10 upon 10 into 10 to the power 6. So what we have to do here, we will put P aluminium is equals to 0.00676 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 10 is power 6 divided by 10. So P aluminium is coming out to be 20,280 pounds, and P aluminium we can say 20.28 pounds. Or you obviously it is not pounds, you have divide with thousand, so it will be kilopounds. So what I have to write down only K. So I can write instead of this K. Okay. I just want to explain you this is kilopounds, so that's why I put KLB. Now PCU, we have to find out the load for this PCU for the copper. So sigma equals to PCU upon area. So PCU equals to sigma into area. So PCU equals to 20 into 2. So therefore PCU equals to 40 kips. Now we have to add and find out the P for both. So total P you can say. So what I have to do, P equals to P aluminium or PCU plus, so it will become 20.28 plus 40. So therefore P equals to 60.28 K. So this will be the maximum load for this. So maximum load we have to apply here is 60.28 kip. So you can see over here what I have done. I have found out deformation for the copper. Then what I have done, I have subtracted this deformation from 0.005 inches that was given in the question. So we got the aluminium deformation 0.006786 in, but the maximum possible deflection or deformation for the aluminium is 0.01 inches, but for this it is only 0.0067 inches. So we have to take the smaller value for the deformation. So for the next, what we have done, we have to find out P aluminium. So for the P aluminium we will use this value, we will not go for the maximum value. So 0.00676 inches equals to P of aluminium divided by 3, area given in the table you can see for the aluminium, this one. So into 10 divided by 10 was the length, it was given 10 inch, and divided by 10 into 10 to the power 6 value of E for the aluminium, it is given in the table. So what we have to do, then we have multiplied it and divided whatever, then we got the load for the aluminium is 20.28. so aluminium can bear this load, and for copper we have to apply the formula for the stress force upon area. So we will get the load for the copper is 40 kips. So what we have to do, we will add both these loads, and what will happen when we add it, then we will get the maximum load which may be applied to the bearing plate. So this will be your answer. So this is the way we can easily calculate it. Hopefully you will understand it. For this numerical is clear to all of you. Thank you so much.